On Friday Night SmackDown, we're preparing for singles action involving that woman, Jade Cargill. And you can see Bianca Belair out here by her tag partner's side tonight.
And her opponent, accompanied by Isla Dawn. She is one half of the WWE Women's Tag Team Champions, Alba Fire!
Alba Fire and Isla Dawn grinning ear to ear with confidence, the reigning WWE Women's Tag Team Champions. Of course, Wade, this is what we alluded to earlier. They became the champions back at Clash at the Castle in Glasgow, Scotland, by defeating not the champions.
Well, arguably speaking, they only have that gold to their name at this point because Blair Davenport assisted them last week in a disqualification against the former champions. And you understand why Jade Cargill and Bianca Belair have been so agreed with this duo. They feel in a straight up two-on-two matchup, they win every single time.
Well, let me ask you this, Wade. In a one-on-one situation as we have tonight, how does Alba Fire approach this matchup, knowing that before the opening bell, she's already out-muscled and overpowered by Jade Cargill? What does a veteran like Fire need to do tonight?
Physically, you simply cannot match Jade Cargill. You need to do what Nia Jax did several weeks ago in the Queen of the Ring tournament. You have to play some mind games with Jade Cargill and make her beat herself. That is a wily veteran way to do it, and Alba Fire certainly has those veteran wiles.
Brace lock applied by Alba Fire. To the surprise of absolutely no one, Cargill has found her way out and is now dominating with her strength yet again.
Alba Fire's certainly been in there with bigger, stronger superstars before, but no one quite like Jade Cargill.
Absolutely incredible power by Cargill. Fire looking for a sunset flip, and Jade put the brakes on, said, not tonight.
Part of the problem with Jade Cargill, you look, you know it's going to be tough, you know she's going to be strong. You can't quite believe it when you lock up with her and realize how much power she actually has.
A super kick by Fire. Cargill continues to march forward.
They rocked Cargill, but that was about it. And that is soul destroying for any superstar when you're throwing your best shots.
For the cover is Fire after the tornado DDT.
Seemingly just bounces off a superhuman superstar like Jade Cargill.
Alba Fire, around we go.
Tying up Jade Cargill in knots. That is one way to do it.
The submission hold wearing down Cargill near the center of the ring. You can see Isla Dawn was debating getting involved, trying to add a little leverage to Alba in the ring until the EST put a stop to that. Look at this! Oh. Nearly put Fire straight through the ring.
An attempt at chicanery, clearly pre-planned, didn't quite work, and now Alba Fire is in a world of trouble. How quickly did this one turn?
Things are about to go from bad to worse. Jaded! Cargill gets the win.
Here is your winner, Jade Cargill!
A downright dominant display tonight by Jade Cargill.
Well, once Jade Cargill got the opportunity, it was like a hot knife cutting through butter.
Oh, wait a second!
Here we go.
Blair Davenport for the second week in a row.
Well, they can take the L, but now it's punishment time for Belair and Cargill. Just like last week, Corey.
Seemingly out of nowhere. I'm sure Blair Davenport has her reasons, but thus far, we're not sure what they are. Hang on. We need a little backup. Naomi has hit the ring.
Completing the big three from WrestleMania. Naomi evens the odds. Blair Davenport has had many crosswords with Naomi of late, but it might be academic as the numbers game simply takes control.
Cargill just kicked Alba Fire's teeth into the fourth row. Big spine buster by Belair.
Naomi has completely turned this dynamic on its head.
Well, Naomi has evened the odds, plain and simple.
The odds don't look even, that's the problem. It's one-way traffic.
A rough night for the WWE Women's Tag Team Champions.